treatment. But in local news now, more testimony today in the case of Robert Jarrett in Howard County. He's the man accused of killing his wife more than two decades ago and burying her body under a shed in their backyard. 11 News reporter Lowell Melzer has been following today's developments in court and joins us live from Ellicott City with more. Lowell?
Yes, Stan, today we finally got a look inside of that shed and what detectives found there. Also, in dramatic fashion, state prosecutors introduced a piece of evidence we told you about a couple of days ago, a concrete slab that was found underneath that shed with the outline of a female body believed to be Christine Jarrett, his wife. Testimony in the Robert Jarrett murder trial continued Tuesday with his brother Brian Jarrett taking the stand. The state asked him about a three-way email correspondence between himself, his brother, and his sister in May of 2012. They were trying to coordinate a family dinner, and his sister wanted to have the dinner at Robert's house, but he was separated from his second wife, Martha, at the time and was not living there. His sister wrote, "Lock Martha in the shed and have it on Claire Drive." Jarrett's brother responded, "Oh my." His sister said, "Was that wrong?" Robert then wrote, "I might need a bigger shed, getting crowded in there." Robert Jarrett's attorney got Brian to admit on the stand that this was a joke. However, given the events that would unfold, Brian said that he felt the email should have been given to the police.
It was nothing but a joke that now they're trying to use as substantive evidence, which it has no place for, because it wasn't evidence of anything other than a family joke, as admitted by Brian.
But the most compelling evidence of the day came in dramatic fashion as state prosecutors wheeled in a large piece of concrete on a hospital gurney that was recovered from underneath the now famous shed in the Jarrett's backyard. Nicholas DiCarlio, a cold case investigator for Howard County, testified that on April 17th, he and a detective visited Jarrett's home where his second wife was living at the time. She gave DiCarlio and the detective permission to search through the shed. DiCarlio told the jury that the two decided to return the next day with the proper tools, so on April 18th, they ended up ripping up the plywood floorboards in the shed and discovered a large concrete mass underneath, which had the outline of a body in it, and once they lifted the concrete, there were skeletal remains underneath it. Jury members got an up-close look at the concrete mass. Most had shocked looks on their faces. And just moments ago, we were able to obtain exclusive video and pictures of that concrete mass. We've posted some of them on our website, WBALTV.com, and we will have that exclusive video for you tonight at 6 o'clock. In the meantime, court continues tomorrow at 9:30 with more testimony from detectives. We're live in Ellicott City tonight. I'm Lowell Melzer, WBAL-TV 11 News. All right, Lowell.